Hello, my name is Maria Zdanowska-Frączek. I work in the Institute of Molecular Physics, Polish Academy of Science in Poznań City in Poland. Today I would like to present some results on the influence of external pressure on the electrical properties of proton conductors. This presentation is the result of my collaboration with Łukasz Lindner, Paweł Ławniczak and Ziemowit Frączek, from the institute in which I work in Poznań, and Tomasz Masłowski from University of Technology of Rzeszów City. Proton conducting materials create a pretty large family of specific ion conductors. In these compounds, the charge carriers are protons, the nuclei of hydrogen atoms, which are the particular type of charge carrier in solid state. Small size and the lack of electron shell are responsible for its involvement in hydrogen bonds. Protons can migrate in the sublattice of hydrogen bonds only. So a prerequisite for long-range proton transfer is the formation of a disordered hydrogen bond network in the structures. Generally accepted is that the fast proton transport in solids proceeds via the Grotthus mechanism. It is a cooperative and dynamic process which involves the proton hopping from one potential well cage to another in hydrogen bond and also an arrangement of its nearest environment. The rate of proton movement depends mainly on the hydrogen bond potential in which the protons are trapped, and therefore on the lengths and angles of H bonds forming the sublattice. Hydrogen bonds are very weak and sensitive to external pressure links in crystals. Even a low pressure can change the geometry of hydrogen bonds, it means change its length and angle. The results of X-ray studies of H-bonded structures at elevated pressures show that the hydrogen bond geometry is closely related to the shape of molecules participating in hydrogen bonding, their arrangement, and the location of H-bonds in the structure. In most materials, the hygroscopic pressure reduces the crystal volume and distances between molecules. That leads to shortening of hydrogen bond length, the potential barriers of protons increase, and in consequence the hopping of protons is slowing down. An example of such behavior are crystals built of planar molecules, benzene, imidazole, pyridine, guanidine, uniformly packed in the structure. In the crystals with an open structure, formed of tetrahedral groups, the external pressure reduces the volume of squeeze crystal. It eliminates possible departures from the close packing by pressing the molecules tighter against their neighbors. These molecules rotate and move into the empty space in the structure until the crystal reaches the energy minimum under new thermodynamic conditions. Consequently, some hydrogen bonds can be stretched depending on the H-bond position, the shape of molecules, and the pressure range. A question is whether the subtle changes in the crystal structure and proton dynamics caused by external pressure affect the process of charge transport in solids, which is a macroscopic property. An example of a crystal built of planar molecules is benzimidazolium azolate. The characteristic structural feature of the salts are parallel two-dimensional layers made of azelaic acid anions chains connected with benzimidazolium cations by hydrogen bonds of NHO type. The flat molecules of benzimidazole are involved in a hydrogen bond path responsible for the proton conduction process. The layers are cross-linked through the weak electrostatic interactions. Our preliminary conductivity studies of benzimidazolium azolate made in a wide temperature range and ambient pressure revealed that the compound is a poor conductor, but peculiar crystal structure makes the salt suitable for conductivity studies under extreme conditions. It is possible to scale sigma AC conductivity in a way proposed by Sommerfeld. The scale spectra collected at different temperatures and constant pressure are arranged on the master curve in a sequence corresponding to speed hopping ion motion. The scaled sigma AC collected at higher temperatures corresponding to the faster ions are located in the low range of scaled frequency values. The isotherms corresponding to the slower ions lie in the range of high values of scaled frequency. So the only visible effect of temperature at ambient pressure is speeding up the hopping motion of the ions. When temperature increases, spectra move toward lower scaled frequencies. Or slowing down the motion, when the temperature goes down, spectra move toward higher scaled frequencies. The scaling procedure at various pressures and constant temperature produce one master curve for all values of pressure. However, now the scale sigma AC for the lowest pressure lies in the range of low scale frequency values. So, in the case of benzimidazolium azolate, the visible effect of compression was the slowing down the ion's hopping motion as a result of crystal squeezing. The scaled conductivity sigma AC spectra collected at different temperatures and those collected at different pressures also superimposed, forming a one master curve. The spectra can shift in frequency scale up or down depending on the type of stimulus. So the apparent effect of stress is opposite to that caused by increasing temperature. The slowing down the motion of hopping ions and in consequence the decrease in conductivity. An example of crystals of open structure formed of tetrahedral groups are solid acids of following stoichiometry. From the family of acid salts, for the purpose of this presentation, I chose the results of ammonium selenate. The stability of individual phases in the salt is determined by the strength of hydrogen bonds network form of ammonium cations, as well as the selenate and ammonium groups dynamics. The consequence of this delicate balance is the occurrence of up to 7 different phases in the crystal. The modification of hydrogen bond geometry and the dynamics of individual structural components will therefore play a key role in phase transformation. The crystal is built of selenate anions and ammonium cations. The characteristic structural feature of the salt are parallel two-dimensional 001 layers made of ammonium cations, each surrounded by 6 selenate groups. 2 of 3 ammonium cations are located between the layers. All ammonium cations, those lying in the plane, and those located between the planes, are involved in the proton transport path in the direction C, perpendicular to these planes. The superprotonic diffusion along C-axis takes place via a two-step Grotthus-like mechanism. The visualization of this process is shown in the next slide. The process involves the proton hopping in hydrogen bond and also reorientation of selenate and ammonium groups involved in proton transport path. The rate of proton movement depends mainly on the hydrogen bond potential in which the protons are trapped and therefore on the length and angles of H bonds forming the sublattice. In this figure, the temperature dependence of sigma dc conductivity collected at various fixed isobaric conditions is presented. The characteristic shifts toward lower temperatures with increasing pressure, it means that hydrostatic pressure stabilizes the superionic phases. Above the superionic phase transition temperature, the slopes of temperature dependencies of electric conductivity under various constant values of pressure are almost the same as that under the ambient pressure. The results indicate that in the studied range, the pressure in practice does not affect electric conductivity in both superionic phases. Also, it considerably changes the phase transition temperature. The pressure temperature phase diagram of ammonium selenate was visible in this figure. The temperature of superionic transition linearly decreases with increasing pressure. It means that with increasing pressure, the range of the superionic phases expands at the expense of the range of the low conductivity one. Let us note that the superionic phase occurs at room temperature under considerable low pressure. Moreover, we have observed a remarkable decrease in the temperature width of ferroelastic phase 3. The results suggest that even small pressures easily destroy the ferroelastic phase 3, which is unstable. We also found the triple point of phase diagram here. At this point, three phases coexisted: ferroelastic phase 4, ferroelastic phase 3, and superionic phase 2. The experimental sigma DC conductivities of each pressure calculated from its bulk resistance, indicated as blue points, are displayed as a function of inverse temperature. In contrast to benzimidazolium azolate, the sigma DC values of ammonium selenate measured at different isobaric conditions increase, so we conclude that both stimuli, temperature and pressure, lead to an increase in conductivity. Next, the proton diffusion process in ammonium selenate at different isobaric conditions was simulated using the kinetic Monte Carlo method using a one-dimensional numerical model of proton diffusion. The influence of pressure on the conduction process was taken into account only by changes in H-bond length and the amplitude of the network vibrations, because these two factors play a crucial role in the diffusion of the proton along the transport path. The results are shown by the red lines. Simulation performed for pressure below 100 MPa show perfect agreement with experimental results when the model included elongation of hydrogen bonds as the effect of pressure increase. The discrepancies between the results of the experimental and computer simulations at pressure 100 MPa results from the proximity of triple point. An additional key result obtained from the simulations is that the behavior of proton conductivity strongly depends on the mutual interplay of the thermal expansion and the lattice vibrations. Let's find a subspace of thermodynamic variables preserving the H-bond potential. We are looking for various thermodynamic conditions in which the impedance spectra and therefore DC conductivity values do not change. The inset shows the PT phase diagram in which the line of points parallel to the phase boundary between phases 2 and 4 indicates the plane in which the similar potential trapped the protons. Indeed, the impedance spectra corresponding to the points from the line have a very same shape and diameter, so the conductivity of the crystal practically does not change. It should be noted that pressure and temperature are independent variables that fully determine the thermodynamic state in the crystal. It is noteworthy that heating the sample only 1 Kelvin, but still staying in the same phase, leads to considerable changes in electric conductivity values. This illustrates how sensitive is the H-bond subsystem to external influences such as pressure and temperature, and the delicate balance between these thermodynamic variables. It also shows that impedance spectroscopy can be a very sensitive tool for studying subtle energy balance in the crystal under the influence of external pressure. We show also that in Taxe crystal, which is built of tetrahedral groups, both stimuli, temperature and pressure, lead to an acceleration of the dynamics of protons and in consequence to an increase in conductivity, which is not the intuitively predictable behavior. Going to conclusion, an impressive result is that effect of pressure on electrical properties of proton conductors depends on the shape of the molecules involved in the H bonds, which form the charge transport pathway in the crystal bulk. In crystals which have an open structure, the pressure effect on AC conductivity spectra is similar to that caused by temperature, Both stimuli lead to acceleration of the dynamics of protons, and in consequence, to an increase in conductivity, which is not the intuitively predictable behavior. These results have shown how complex is microscopic behavior underlying to the observed macroscopic response to the change in the thermodynamic conditions. It is noteworthy that the impedance spectroscopy can be a very sensitive tool for studying subtle energy balance which determines proton transport in crystals. Special thanks go to Professor Ashour and organizing committee who made every effort to ensure that the meeting, sought in a modified form, could be held. Thank you for your attention.